There has been a controversy whether the honourable judges of the constitutional court, namely the honourable Supreme Court and the High Court, should be called by the prefix as a lordship or a prefix as a sir or your honour. Yesterday, Delhi High Court has taken a decision. The Registrar General of the Delhi High Court has issued a letter to all honourable judges and the principal district judges in the state of West Bengal and requested them that in view of the decision taken by the Chief Justice of Kolkata High Court, there is no need to call the honourable judges of the High Court as my lord or lordship in all correspondences. Let us go in the history book. This controversy goes back to 2006. There was a petition which was filed before the Honourable Supreme Court of India and the submission was advanced saying that the British have left the India in 1947, but we are carrying that legacy as it is. Why should we follow that legacy and use the prefix as a word, prefix as a lord? We are also aware that in the constitution there is a article which says that abolition of titles, and lord was one of the title which was given by the British at that point of time. So in view of that, the matter was filed before the Honorable Supreme Court of India. Supreme Court honorable judges were wise enough. They said that we have no difficulty, you can go back to Bar Council of India and let Bar Council of India decide in what manner a honorable judges should be called before the in the court of law. Then in the month of April 2006, Bar Council of India passed a resolution. By virtue of that, it was made clear that you will have to show respect to the honorable judges of the constitutional court, namely the Supreme Court and the High Court. There is no need to call them as a lord. Bar Council of India took further decision to call them by a prefix which is known as sir or your honor. So therefore, these were the resolutions which were passed, which were followed by the different bar associations. And lastly, in the day before yesterday, the Kolkata High Court has also followed that. The question is, are we able to throw that particular baggage which we are carrying despite the Britishers left India in the year 1947 and we got a freedom? Are we able to introduce our own system, or whether we are still the slaves of that particular tradition which has been followed and criticized for years together? It's a time for all advocates to think about this. It's a time for all law students to think about this. And in the correspondence also, whether we should use this word lord and lordship is also replied. And now the Kolkata High Court has made it clear. Now it's a question for all of us, namely the student of law, namely the advocates who are practicing. Speaking for myself, you must have seen whenever I was appearing before the Honorable High Court and the Supreme Court, most of the time I have used the word sir. Most of the time you might have noticed that I use the word your honor. This particular word was used by my senior also. So therefore, there is a legacy so far as such a prefix which was used for showing the respect to the honorable judges. Now it's a turn when we should come out of that British colonial concept of lordship. Now let us use our Indian system, maybe by sir, maybe by your honor, maybe by Sriman. Choice is ours, but one thing is sure, we will have to show respect to the honorable judges, be it a Supreme Court judge, be it a High Court judge, be it otherwise judge. To show respect, how, in what manner, in what word, that is a question. Instead of the word lord and the lordship or ladyship, there are several better words, and our body, namely the Bar Council of India, has also recommended that. So let us start using these new words, namely sir, madam, your honor. Let us try to understand what makes a lot of difference for all of us. Let us throw that baggage of British colonial system and let us make our system as our own Indian system. Thank you.